We knew the Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine was good. Now we know it's even better. Updated results from its trial reveal it is in fact 95% effective and will also protect against the elderly.
Every time another 5 or 10 million people are immunized and carrying this really high level of protective neutralizing antibodies, that's a big step closer to you going back to the pub or having your job safe or having your business safe and getting out of this mess. And these are really big, exciting steps.
43,000 people were involved in the trials. The latest data shows 170 became infected with the virus, but only 8 of those had been given the vaccine. The rest had had a placebo. It's also proven hugely effective in older people whose immune response can be weaker, and only 2% had very mild side effects like headaches and fatigue. The biotech firm now just needs regulators to approve an emergency license, paving the way for national use.
The news this week of further successful vaccine trials with Moderna and today's update from Pfizer has given rise to the very real prospect of an effective vaccine in the near future. A vaccine still has to go through a regulatory process, but it is right that the planning of the huge logistical exercise of a vaccine rollout led by the NHS is now very much underway.
The news came as senior government advisers confirmed they are planning to lift some restrictions over Christmas, raising hopes we will be allowed to see extended family for a few days.
We are very keen that we have Christmas as close to normal as possible. That requires all of us to make every effort over this national restriction period and even in early December to get the cases as low as possible and to reduce the risk of transmission within households and between families. A final decision, of course, will rest with the government.
Any indulgement at Christmas, though, would mean we have to pay for it in the new year.
I'm going to miss you.
I'm going to miss you.
Yes.
Jennifer and her girls wouldn't mind. They'd do anything just to be with their granny.
My mum's on her own, you know, and she really needs us. She gets really sad at this time of year because my dad died just after Christmas. So this is, you know, a sad time of year anyway. So to kind of compound it by not being able to spend it as a big family, it'd just be awful.
We'll find out next week who we can and can't see at Christmas. There's no doubt millions of us will be hanging on the government's every word.